medium and heavy weights and or objects today. Towel, water bottle, of course. You got some longer blocks today, so taking those quick little breaks as need them, sipping water rather than guzzling it through. We're going to start off with a 5-minute dynamic warm-up. So a little bit longer warm-up today as we've had the past couple days anyway. It's really going to get your body warmed up. So make sure you work your way through it. Wake yourself up here. We'll start off on the floor with a cat camel, palms under shoulders, knees under hips, 30 seconds, driving that back up and then pulling that belly button in. Right from there, we're going to go into thread the needle. We'll spend 30 seconds on each side, dropping that shoulder towards the floor, alternating once we hit the 30-second mark. So we're going to do 30 seconds on one side, then 30 seconds on the other. If you do alternating, that's fine too. It's not that big of a deal. We'll just go be there for a minute. High plank to plank pike. So high plank position, pushing up heels towards the floor, coming back, setting that high plank position. From there, we'll go to the plank walkout. So I would just start from the plank, walk it all the way back, and then walk it all the way back into a plank position. After we're done with that plank series, we're going to go into a squat, 5-point squat. So we'll hinge over, reach the toes or as low as you can, drop your butt down, one arm, other arm, and then we'll stand it up from there. And then we're going to finish off 30 seconds on a power skip. So by the time we get done here, guys, you should be fully warmed up, okay? So take it down, hands and knees. We'll start with that cat camel for 30 seconds. Just kind of waking up that back before we get into the thread the needle. Here we go, friends. Let's do it in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Round in the back, and then pulling the belly button in.
Yeah, man.
So we back in the foot with the bodies rocking from side to side, side, side to side.
Finish up that rep, and then we're going thread the needle. 3, 2, 1. You can just work one side here. You can alternate. I'm going to go one side. I'll let you know when 30 seconds is up. Drawing that belly button in, dropping that shoulder towards the floor. About the rotation through your spine. Let's do one more on this side and then switch. After this, go into the high plank position, up into a pike. Let's finish one more. In 3, 2, 1. Come up into that high plank position. Push the hips up.
Keep down and drinks like this. No,
and push the armpits towards the floor.
Now,
a nice stretch. Coming back to the high plank.
When the music drops, we both put our hands up. Put your hands on my body. Swear I've seen you before.
Super slow.
Eyes,
and controlled motion here. We've got about 15 more seconds. All right, guys, come back to your high plank and then walk your hands back to your toes and all the way up. Roll those shoulders out a couple times and then walk it back. Walk back, find the plank. Trying to take small steps with your hands. That's going to help warm those shoulders up. That nice hamstring stretch we'll also get on the next exercise.
Dance, dance like it's the last.
Let's kind of shake it out here. And then you go into that 5-point squat. We're going to hinge over, reach for the toes. You can hold on to your toes if you can get that far. Drop that booty low. One arm, the other. Stretch it out to the top. If you can't get all the way to your toes, guys, you can bend those knees a little bit. Oh, I can finally hear things. They're painting here in Alamo today, so all I've heard is the compressor. All right, we got about 8 seconds. Hit that last breath. Let's take it to those power skips. All right, hopefully we feel pretty warm now. We are gonna grab a couple of sets of weights here. So probably your heavy and your medium would be my guess. Longer block, we got 10 minutes of work. So we're just gonna work our way through it, taking your time as you go, taking those little breaks as you need them, okay? First exercise, medium to heavy weights here. Ground to press, feet about hip distance. We're gonna go as low as we can. Dropping that butt down, keeping your chest open. Hammer curl, shoulder press in a fluid motion. So from the bottom to the top, and then you'll reset on the way down. Once you're done with 10 reps of that, you got swing lunges. I would start in the reverse lunge position. We're gonna bring that leg from the back to the front, 90 degree bend, push into the reverse lunge. You're trying to not stop in the middle. If you need to, you can take a little pause. Then you've got a bear plank. So we're gonna get into our bear plank position. We're gonna walk out into a high plank. You have a shoulder tap, trying to keep those hips from moving. Then you're gonna keep your butt down and walk back into the bear plank. Now you're only doing 5 of those. Your quads should be burning by the time you're done, as well as your chest and maybe the shoulders too, okay? Last exercise, single arm bicycle chest press. So the opposite arm is down. You're gonna press up as you extend away, pull in. Okay. Now you can keep your shoulder blades up off the floor. You could bring your head to the floor if you need that support with your neck. Okay, and you'll do 5 on each arm. Super slow controlled tempo. We got 10 minutes here, starting off with ground to press. If you guys need anything else, let me know. Here we go. Ground to press for 10. 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. So be explosive on the drive and slow it down on the recovery. That belly button pulled in as you press those weights up and overhead. Now, you could add some challenge to that swing lunge. A little weight, but make sure you have your balance first. Forwards and backwards to count as one rep. Thank you. stair plank. You step out with your hands. Set the high plank. And then walk it back. So we're not going to rush through here today, guys. We've got a lot of time. Take our time. And execute with control. That bear plank. And feel free to go as heavy as you can on the bicycle press.
I've been loving everything you are. Your eyes alone are the brightest stars. I could stand you all night. Just drinking in your sun.
Get through that round. If you need a little breather, take it. Get back to work.
Our dreams are where you'll find me. You're the only thing I, you're the only thing I see. Our dreams are where you'll find me. Your lips like galaxies.
That forward lunge. You want to step out and lunge down, not push forward. So you're still looking for about a 90 degree bend in both knees. If you added the weight to it, you're not stopping in the middle, you're swinging all the way through. That bear plank, guys. Make your shoulders work. Step out to that plank. Pull the belly button in once you're there, and then do that shoulder tap. And then reset the bear plank at the back before you start your next rep. Okay? So that's not a quick move. That's a much more controlled movement on that one. And again, on that bicycle chest press, if you need to keep your head on the floor, you can, but the challenge will be to bring those shoulders up off the floor.
Breathe in the air, the light that surrounds me. If we hold ourselves together, we'll go far. Created a space, in my head it was empty. But I know that I want to be where you are.
Not quite there yet.
We have a purpose, but to take that leap, you must recognize the person that's inside.
Going back to ground test. Pull that belly button in. To walk out, you're going to do one more rep. If you're on anything else, you're going to do two more reps, and then you can put those weights down and grab a sip of water. Okay, here we go. Block number two. So this is our big cardio here, okay? This is our big cardio. We're going to start with a squat jack to tap down. We have a 10-minute block. Once we're done, we'll get a 30-second rest, and we'll do it again, okay? So the first two intervals are push and base. Your push, squat jack to floor tap, back up, okay? Now, you wanted a little more of a challenge, and you had a set of light weights. I suppose you could hold the weights at your chest, come down, tap, all right? But that's the total challenge, okay? And the weight should be pretty light. Your option would be step out, squat down, step out, squat down, get as low as you can to the floor. Your base, guys, is jumping jacks, okay? You all know the low impact option right here. So those are both a minute. Then we got a push, squat, knee to elbow. Squat, knee to elbow. Option, slow it down. You're all out on this block, friends. Is a running man driving the knees in. Belly button's pulled in. Then we're gonna go back to squat to knee to elbow. We're gonna do another all out. We'll get another 30 seconds rest, okay? So just listen up as we go. You'll be fine. You know where you're starting on this push. Squat jacks with a floor tap. Here we go. In 3, 2, 1, let's do it. Oh, come on, Jack. Joe, there we go.
We've lost our minds.
Weights in the heels as you jump out in that squat. Quick tap in the middle.
We the feet. Are the ones that are and are not.
So we're halfway. Check in here, okay?
We're told that our mistakes are all that we are. The cost that comes with getting up.
Jumping jacks and now active recovery. Five. Back to base. Three, two, one. Here we go. Remember, guys, the whole challenge, right?
We give away, but then we keep it. We created this as what we're with you.
Rather than stopping, take the jump out. Keep those arms moving.
Never seem to make a lot of sense. We never really
got 30 seconds.
The fact that gravity pushes us.
Watch me to elbow coming up. Guys, ride those knees in right here. Come on. More than halfway. 10 seconds. Back into the push, the all out. Squats and knee to elbow, coming in 10.
So carry on, moving forward.
All right, start marching in place with hands. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Out of sight, out of mind, it's no wonder we never seem to exist.
Stay aggressive.
Sing for the one you love the most. Careful, she's
eyes on the floor.
Right down
halfway.
The hall. We cannot say we will not evolve.
8 seconds.
So we set sail, carry on, moving forward.
One.
Another step.
We got a minute here. Okay. As you start to recover, when you're ready, you can take it back into a march in place.
You'd be the one to work on.
that same thing again.
All right. You'd lay awake at night and scheme of all the
start with squat jacks and floor tap.
Change, but it was just a dream.
More exercise, a little rest, and then that push to all out. Five, squat jacks, floor tap. Three, one, let's go. Find that same tempo. From your first round. Squat down. Chest lifted. Low hand. Tap it out.
Right.
Good? All right. Here we go. Grab your heavy weights. We're going to start with a weighted alternate reverse lunge. Don't grab your heavy weights. To lateral raise. Maybe you're medium, maybe you're small, okay? So we're going to step back into that reverse lunge position. We're going to hold it. Oops, don't hit the wall. You're going to raise the arms to the side. I'll try to do this front on for you guys. So we'll step back, reverse lunge, lateral raise, come back up, other leg goes back, set the lunge, hold the core, and raise the weights. If you need an option, elbows at 90, you're lifting the elbow out, okay? Now, the second exercise, you might be able to go a little heavier. We're gonna deadlift, back is nice and flat, eyes are on the floor. We're gonna come back up, we're gonna set, you have an upright row, okay? So all of these movements, well, the first three are compounds. You got two exercises in one, so split them up, okay? Third exercise, lateral lunge. Set your position, which is not feet together. It's feet hip distance. You have a bicep curl. Step out, hip distance feet, bicep curl. So those are all 10 total, okay? Neutral full thruster, palms face in, same squat from that full ground to press. You're gonna press it up and then reset just like you did on the ground to press. And then your last exercise, just a basic crunch, man. Just 20 reps, feet flat on the floor, lift the chest, come back down, don't rush it. Take your time through it. This is meant to be a little bit of recovery, okay, before you start your next round. Now, I might bump this block back to 10 minutes, okay? So don't feel like you have to rush. Try to go as heavy as you can. Take little breaks if you need it. But let's go, guys. Let's build some strength. Here we go. Reverse lunge to lateral lunge in 3, 2, or lateral raise in 3, 2, 1. Let's go.
Motivation, you can do more and better. Motivation.
thruster when you get there. Belly button's in, right? Get back into the heels. Strong through the core. Be explosive as you drive. Everybody, got 3.5 to go. Got belly button pulled in, whatever you're doing. Out. Shave shoulders in front of your body. Just like the deadlifts on the bottom. Upright row on the top. We got now 2 minutes. Glad they gave us a little more time. I have no idea how many reps I've done. I totally went into a zone on those upright rows. Forgot to keep counting. Guys, we got about 15 seconds here. Get in a couple more. In 3, 2, 1, take a break. Take a break. Okay. Here's what I'm going to propose. I want to finish off with a little more cardio strength. So we have one move. We're going to go for 6 rounds total, so 3 minutes, okay? There's no visual aid for it. I'll give you a screen just so you can get some music going. You're gonna take your medium or heavy weight, up to you. You could also go lightweight. We're gonna set our feet wide, so ground to press, but like you had a med ball, okay? So one weight only, going from the bottom to the top, back down. So I want a little more of a sumo stance. We want the weight between the legs rather than on the outside, okay? We're gonna press up and over, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We're gonna do 6 rounds total to finish it off, and then we'll stretch, okay? Let me grab my trusty stopwatch. So pick your poison on the weights, guys. Let me get you a screen here. Has nothing to do with what you're doing, but you got some music. All right, you guys ready? Here we go. 20 seconds of work in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Push the heels. Halfway. Belly button's in here. 3, 2, 1, rest. Weight down. Don't go too far though. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Change the weight if you need to. That's holding tight. Halfway. Woo! 3, 2, 1. Rest. Again, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Lead those quads at the top, halfway. Woo, now those shoulders. 5, 3, 2, 1, rest. We're halfway. Here comes round. 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. 4 and 6. We're almost there. Yes. Yes, team. Yes, come on. Halfway.
I've been living a long time for
yes,
this
chest
day
up.
To
three,
come
two,
and
one, rest.
I keep dreaming of
you got two more. Stick with it. Here we go. In three, two, one, let's go. Woo! Nice work. Yeah, that was a good one. Thanks for playing around with me on that last block, if you will. Okay, here we go. Maybe walk around for a minute. Let's take those arms up and down. In through the nose, out through the mouth. You can keep moving your legs here. Up, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Oh. Starting to calm that heart rate down now. Okay, exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. All right. Let's take those arms up overhead. Grab onto a wrist. Pull yourself over to one side. Let's hold it here for 20 seconds. All right. So new month, new goals. Set some new goals for yourself this month, guys. I'm going to be doing some outdoor boot camps. Not this weekend, it's a holiday weekend, but starting the following weekend, every big holiday weekend. Yes, my husband's birthday is on Friday. It's a big holiday weekend in our house. Shake it off here. Other side, arm up, pull it over. What was I saying? So boot camp starting a week from Saturday, and I'll do those every Saturday, 8 a.m., probably at Osage Park, unless you guys have a better venue that you want to check out. So let me know. And then Kat is working on getting some done for you Livermore folks, okay? So if you have her social media, reach out to her and let her know if you're interested. Shake it off here. Take an arm across the body, shoulder down, pull it in. This weekend, you'll have Kat and Sarah on Friday. Kat's doing 6:15, Sarah's doing 9:10 a.m. It is not a down and dirty 30 on Friday. They made it a regular workout. So just be prepared for that. Switch sides. And then on Saturday and Sunday this weekend, 9 a.m. Okay, Saturday and Sunday are 9 a.m. this weekend only. And there will be no Zoom classes on Monday. So start to prepare for yourself with an outdoor workout. Maybe do something different, something you've been wanting to do on Monday, the holiday. Okay, go and release this side, 3, 2, and 1. Shake it off a little bit here. Bring those elbows out. Nice big chest stretch here. Oh, that was a good workout. Good strength. Yesterday was a good strength day too. So we might be seeing a trend this week. We'll see. I haven't looked at tomorrow's template yet. Go and bring those elbows down. Shake it off, take them behind you, while your hands behind you. Roll your shoulders back, open your chest up here. And if you guys were not on the email for the boot camp or didn't see my social media post and you want to be on that email, let me know. Okay, you can just chat me on Zoom. But I'm just, as we go, growing that list and it'll keep getting bigger and send the invite out to everybody. Release those arms, shake it off. Pull one heel up, a little standing quad stretch here. We'll do the other side, one big deep stretch, and then we'll be done. It's so quiet in here now. They're the like I was saying, they're painting the complex in Alamo. So the whole class, like in my ear, was a freaking compressor. It was just dull background noise. Couldn't hear myself think. But we made it. So that's good. Release this foot, hold it in front of the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take those feet out wide. Nice deep breath in, coming all the way up. Lean it back and release. You guys are done. Great work today, everybody. Thanks for spending your lunch hour with me. Have a good, yes, have a good rest of your Tuesday. And maybe see you Thursday, same time. Bye.